here is the gasket for petrol engine. These are normally used, very common local kit and very reliable also. They are working very well if they are good, but with the passage of time they become a little bit crappy and defective, so then they need repair. We are going to make repair on this one, and this is also not performing very well for my alternator or gas engine, gas generator. So here is the intake from where this gas is in. Here you can see this in is, so gas line is connected over here, and then here this line is connected to the engine. This is out, of course it is written. Here is two controls are there. One control is here, this is the main fuel control, and here is another, the outlet fuel control. So these two we are adjusting according to the need, according to the good starting and according to the good running efficiency we are getting by these two controls. Once they are set to the proper setting, then the engine is running without any, flawlessly it is running without any trouble, it can run. So to open this kit, this is a very simple device actually. If you understand one time, it is easy to manage and it is easy to repair. Then you have to need an appropriate size Allen key, which should open these all six Allen key screws or bolts. So these we are going to open. I'm going to show you internal interior of the kit. Hope this will work for many people, because these generators and these engines are very common with people. They have, so if they went defective, it's a good time to repair them yourself, and it is easy even to maintain. They are not very difficult to. So all we have to open and the testing, of course. Just I have to give you a little demonstration on the testing. If you are push air here by your mouth, the air should not go in by pressure, and if you suck over here, you should take air from here. This is what is the proper testing, and this should be blocked over here. This is the testing, the very simple testing you can perform for your gasket, whether it is good or bad. So all opened. Now it's the time to remove this cover from. While you remove this cover from, you can see this is just a cover. Here is a hole. These two holes should be cleaned as they are. And here is the diaphragm. You can see, so this diaphragm is needed to be removed by this way. You can remove it from, and then later on this will come off by this way. You can see inside there is a lever which is holding this diaphragm from the center pivot. You have to remove it by this way. So it's removed now, you can see, and here is the part just needs servicing. Here these two screws are, and this is rusty. You can see the rust is due to moisture in the gas, and this metal of course is very very bad quality. So you can grab your screwdriver, a Phillips screwdriver can do, an appropriate size Phillips screwdriver you have to use, not to ruin the screws. It's not difficult to remove them, they are not too tight. There is a spring also downside, you can see. So just remove these two screws, and then later on you can see there is dirt inside. This dirt is needed to be removed, and this pivot is needed to be cleaned and lubricated a little bit. And also this one is important, this area is important to clean. This is actually the part, the rubber part, which is stopping the gas. And here also, here you should stop it, because this is, you can see the intake for the gas, and here the spring will go here of course, and this is giving a little bit pressure on. This is the adjustment for the gas quantity. So here we are going to clean these parts just with a little emery sandpaper. I can sand it over here, and I can sand it over here of course, so to make it clean. And then little bit lubrication I will provide here, and we'll fix this all thing. Here are the parts. Just we are going to remove some piece of with a piece of sandpaper. We are going to remove some dirt from like this. This is the rubber. We are going to clean it. Already I did it. Now it's cleaned. And here also these pivots, pivot part. I have to clean it. And then later on this end tick, I have to clean it by this way. Already I did it. And there should be no sharp edges. And cleaned like this. Here also a little bit to clean where the lever will function on the fulcrum, like this, and then a tap so that the dirt should be removed from. Next is the parts to be fixed. So here is this lever part, and then there was a spring also. So this spring part I have to fix in, just place it there. And then later on a little bit lubrication is required on the fulcrum, so regular motor oil will do. Just little bit lubrication you have to provide here and here. That's it. And then this lever part, I have to put it on here by this way. And the two screws we have to fix. Two screws on these locations, we have to fix them. Another screw over here. We have to tighten it, not too much, so that this lever should move very easily. We will tighten up to this extent. If we tighten too much, then the lever will not move, which is not the desirable. The desired way is we have to tighten it up to the position that this lever should move easily. We have to loose this one a little bit like this. Now you can see this lever can move in very easily. So this is what is the proper place where the extent where should wear we have to tighten. Some way like this, and this one also to tighten a little bit so that it will not restrict the motion, but it should keep everything in place. Some way like this. And now the time to fix this place also, I have to clean it a little bit. And here this lever or this whatever the actuator, just I cleaned it also, and I have to put it in like this and line this up, this diaphragm here, line it up with the holes. All are nearly the same, so this should go. And there should be no holes in the diaphragm. You can see there was a hole before, just I repaired it. I mended it over here with some epoxy or something like that. I mended it before, and there should be no holes, nothing. This should be a perfect diaphragm. Now is the time to fix this cover. And of course there is one position on which these two screws are the fixation for the engine. So I have to put them up because this engine is in the way. Not these screws, these two are the places where it will be hold on the engine. So this I have to fix it in the way that it should come to the top. The top is here, not here, but the top is here. The top is here. Better if you will make some mark before opening. Some marks are here before I did. You can see these are the marks. So this will be the top, and these two positions should come to the top. And then in the reverse order, I have to fix all the screws back to fix everything as they were. And of course this adjustment, as I said, the two adjustments, those we will be making on the engine. We will put the adjustments in some certain position and then install this kit on the engine, and then there we will start it. We will start the engine and we'll make the adjustments to the optimum condition, optimum driver running of the engine and optimum starting condition. This is what is the procedure for the alignment and adjustment of the screws and whatever the items are inside. It's a little bit difficult to speak there along with the start engine. What I will do and will show on the camera what I'm doing, so you will see. But it's difficult to listen to me in that place where the engine will run, because you will listen too much noise of the engine there. But what I will do is I will adjust this one and will just adjust this one to for the optimum performance. Here is the after setting this kit. This is my gas intake line, and this line is going to the carburetor. You can see here is the carburetor downside after this filter, and this this is the gas line which is just we put it in free. There is no gas tank. You can see this is by the gas only, not by gasoline, by gas, the which is natural gas. By that we are running. Here is no cover. You can see we will put that cover later on. And now I'm going to set this kit as I deeply I set this screw and this bolt. We will set for the good performance. I will show you how to do it. Now we are going to start it, and just you will see aligning this bolt. This I will adjust, but you will not be able to listen because this will create too much sound, too much noise. I'm going to start it, and we will see for the better starting and better running condition. Condition and the engine is running well at this place. So this is the optimum optimum setting for this gasket with this engine. I'm going to